After logging into TeamCity, we're presented with the overview page. Now this is basically our homepage. This is where we work from. We can access projects from here, access our changes, access agents, build queue, as well as update information about our profile and tools, etc. Let's take a look at projects. In order to access a project, we can hover over to the drop-down arrow next to projects, and a list of projects will be displayed to us. We can scroll through or just type the name of the project and navigate directly to it. We can also access this drop-down list by pressing the P button on the keyboard. If we type the name of a project and hit enter, we can then go directly to that project's homepage. Before going further, let's just describe what a project and a build configuration is in TeamCity. Here, for instance, we have Kotlin, which is an open source language that we're developing at JetBrains. Now, Kotlin in itself can consist of multiple sub-projects. There can be the compiler and plugin, there can be a library, which is, for instance, K-Annotator, etc. In TeamCity, we can have a single project, and inside this project, have multiple build configurations. A build configuration can correspond to a sub-project, for instance, a compiler and plugin, in this case, but it can also correspond to a specific configuration environment for a specific project. For instance, I could have a build configuration that refers to a production release of the compiler and plugin, whereby it does not have debug information or certain level of logging. And I could have a build configuration that corresponds, for instance, to a test deployment of the compiler and plugin, where it does have debug symbols and certain integration tests, for instance, are not executed. So not only can we have a single project and then different build configurations corresponding to different projects, but we can also have a build configuration corresponding to a sub-project, but with different settings for that build to run. Here in this case, we can see that the Kotlin project has a build configuration called compiler and plugin. It has another one called compiler and plugin idea. It has another one called K-Annotator, etc. And each of these have their actual run of the build configuration. Let's go back to the overview page. Now, what we would ideally want to happen is that when we log into TeamCity, we see the projects that we're interested in. And we can do this in TeamCity by configuring visible projects. By clicking on the link, we can see a list of all hidden projects and those visible on the left-hand side. We can select those that we want from the right-hand side. For instance, I will select Amazon API Client and IntelliJ IDSCE and move them over to the left. I can also look for a project by typing its name. And I can also reorder the projects on the left-hand side. So for instance, I can say move Kotlin all the way to the top. When I click Save, TeamCity will now display those projects for me and only those projects when I log in. I can still access all of the other projects by going to the drop-down box, but by default, I now see the projects that I'm mainly interested in. At any time, I can change this configuration by clicking on Configure Visible Projects and add or remove more to the list. On this project page, we can now expand or collapse a specific project by using the arrows, or we can collapse and expand all projects by using the buttons at the top. Collapse all will collapse all, and expand all will expand all, including all of the build configurations. On each of these projects, we can see that on the right-hand side, we have little X's. What this allows us to do is hide a specific build configuration. Now we can see that up here, we have a label that says no hidden build configuration. But as soon as I click this X box, what will happen is that now I will have the label updated saying that there is one build configuration that's hidden. In order for me to show that again, I just hover over to the drop-down button and click Show. So at any time, I can now have a series of visible projects and only display from those visible projects the build configurations that I'm interested in. Additionally, we can also hide successful configurations. We can see here that we have multiple build configurations and the result of the last run of each build configuration varies. Here we see that everything has passed, here we see that things have failed. If I only want to see those that have failed, I can click on the checkbox Hide Successful Configurations and that will hide it for me. Displaying only those that have not been successful. At any time, we can just select all of them again by unchecking the checkbox. So very easily, we can customize TeamCity so that it only displays the information we want by configuring the visible projects and the build configurations we're interested in.